First to be a Monet. Has the same style that he enjoyed in Paris after the Exposition Universelle. The same delicate, powdery interpretations combined with great vigor and expressiveness.
Great vigor? Randy little painter, was he? Well, no complaints about my view either.
Okay, you know what? Is everything with you sexual?
No. Okay, so you've never thought about me? I'd even just date little. And that was good, wasn't I? Come on, Prue. I'm not pushing this. I know where you stand. I just want to know where I stand.
How are you two doing?
We're fine. Exactly where we should be at the moment.
As long as it's authentic.
You don't have to worry about us, Mr. Caldwell.
Do I have to worry about us?
What's on the Monet?
Yeah, and you were right. There are some unexplained thread markings in the area around the station, as well as the signature area. Not yet. I was hoping to talk you into going home first. Prue, you're exhausted. Hey, Aunt Piper is going to be fine.
It takes a lot to scare me.
I'm really not good at this saying the right thing stuff. You know what? Why don't you go back to the hospital and I'll stay here and handle everything, okay? Morning.
Hi.
Hey. So, how's Piper doing?
Fully recovered.
What? That's great.
Yeah, I just came in early to confirm a few suspicions.
Wait, back up. Piper's okay? Okay, shoot.
I mean, I know that it looks perfect from the outside and...
Look, Prue, come on. I know we've had our difficulties and maybe our relationship isn't everything you hope for, but...
Jack, it's not real. Didn't paint it. One of his students did.
Are you sure? So what? Prue, if someone wants to believe in something that may not be altogether true, but is true enough for them, then what's the harm in letting it be?
Jack.
Prue, the world is made up of almost perfect. It's nothing but near misses and necessary compromises. And a little bit of both. Just asking you to not look so close. Nothing bears up under that kind of scrutiny. Yeah, that too. You go with it. Everything's gonna be fine. Hey, I just heard. Are you out of your mind?
I don't know, maybe.
Come on, Prue. You can't be serious. You can't just quit.
I Caldwell accepted it.
Why? Just because he doesn't agree with you about selling the Monet?
It's not authentic, Jack.
You know what? Buyers think it is. And they've been thinking that way for over 100 years.
So it's worth whatever someone's willing to pay for it, right?
Yeah, right.
No, it's wrong. Before everyone cared...
Including me, right?
I've been thinking about this for a while, and it's changed me.
So what are you going to do?
Look, I had a little...
Or being with someone you really don't want to be with.
You have been great. You've opened me up to so many new things. Made me feel wanted again.
But...
But I need to be alone for a while. No strings.
Good Lord!
Of course, an item is only worth as much as someone is willing to pay. Jack Sheridan from Sheridan Internet Auctions. If you own it, I can sell it.
Okay, how nice for you, but this is my appraisal.
Oh, and it's a very impressive one, too. But can you guarantee this nice lady that someone will actually pay $5,000 for this at auction? To give you $1,000 cash today.
Yeah, well, then you would be robbing her of $4,000.
But you said yourself that you can't guarantee that. Well, would you like to find out yourself? I can have $1,000 cash for you this afternoon. What do you say?
I say so. Here's my... And I'll see you there this afternoon.
It's a deal.
Cut. And that's a wrap. Excellent, folks.
For you.
Look, forgive me. I wanted to be on the same stage as Prue Hollowell.
Why?
Because it gives my startup company instant credibility, that's why. You know, if the other specialists at Buckland's have your expertise and talents, I turned them down last year. But I don't lie. You know what? I better get to the bank. I have a wand to buy.
Want to bet? Oh, you.
Ah, thrilled to see me, I see. Yeah, this is Buckland's obviously pays better than I thought. I followed your scent. Now that is a classy perfume, though I'm hardly surprised. Could I have my wand back, please? And I couldn't contact her because her address mysteriously fell out of my pocket somehow. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Isn't that a little juvenile? And war over juice cups?
You know it. But all's fair in love and war.
Piper?
Crew, I'm kind of in a hurry here, so if I could just get my wand.
Leo, keep working with Kyle just in case. Us out the back door. Out the back door!
Don't you have some other house to repair?
Jack is pretty cute. I just thought...
Hold it! What's wrong with this picture? Oh, keen eye, Prue. Where's the value of the wand, don't you think? Come on. Have a drink. You can brag to me how you outsmarted me with the wand. I do like to learn from the best. Bartender. Pondering the possibilities. Redecoration? I mean, where's your flair in this place? The Prue.
Well, I don't really think that's any of your business, Jack. Now, if you don't mind, I have a lot of work to do, so perhaps you could go annoy somebody down the hall?
Actually, already did. Signed the dotted line, they sent me to my office. Well, it's only temporary, of course, until mine is ready. Well, you said we couldn't date and work together, so since you won't date me, one out of the two will have to do. If you can get away with wearing that, I can certainly get away with wearing this. I mean, no wonder nobody gets any work done around here. You look... well. Well, got me this job.
Okay, look.
Tell you what, and make myself comfy.
It's really nice form, but the dismount could use a little work.
Meant to do that! Hey, that was my favorite auctionette. Oh, nice one. Hey, listen, I just wanted to let you know that since you're not here, I'm going to take your 12 o'clock lunch with Mr. Fujimoto. Would you relax? I will take great care of your client, okay? Later.